हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एडवांस फीचर्स ऑफ एमएस एक्सेल प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट। एज आई एक्सप्लेन द थियोरी पार्ट, सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट, हाउ वी कैन इम्प्लीमेंट दीज थिंग्स। लाइक आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सॉर्टिंग ऑफ डेटा, देन फिल्टरिंग डेटा, देन द अदर थिंग वॉज दैट एडवांस फिल्टर, ऑटो फिल्टर, एंड द लास्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज गोल सीक। So these are the four different things which I will be discussing in the practical part. First of all, what is sorting of data? Sorting of data basically means arranging the given data according to a particular order. If I am been given this data, suppose these values has been given to us. So what I will be doing? I will be just selecting this range of data. I am selecting this range of data. Now I am going to the data option. See, this is data option. Data option it is there. And then if I'll be clicking on this, this is smallest to largest. So if I'll be clicking, so it will be arranged on the basis of smallest to largest. So this is in the ascending order. If I'll be clicking in the order of largest to smallest, so it will be arranged in the form of largest to smallest. So this is one of kind of sorting of data. The other method we can use is select the range of data. This was method one. Now the other method is that select the range of data. I am selecting once again the range of data, and then in the data group you are finding sort option. Sort, if I am clicking, so these are the values. It has been values, sort by column and the largest. Why it is written sort by column n means this value is given in the n column. The values which I have entered is in the n column. That's why it is showing sort by column n, then the values and the largest to smallest it is showing. If I want to arrange from smallest to largest, then I can arrange it easily. So this is sorting of data. Means sorting means arranging the data in either in ascending form or descending form. And the use I have discussed earlier also, how to use it. So these are the arrangement. You are able to see that these are arranged in ascending order. And if I will be selecting again, and if I want to arrange, so I can arrange in descending order also. If I will be clicking this, so these are arranged in descending order also. So this is one kind of sorting of data. Now the other part we will be discussing is filtering of data. Filtering means, I have already explained that filtering means selecting or the input or the data which we want is the desired data. That is known as filtering of data. So filtering means selecting only that much range of data which we are requiring. Not requiring the data which we are not requiring will be filtering it. So the for this also we have to select the range of data. First thing is that we should be selecting the ranges of data. I have selected this range of data. Now I'll be going to the filter option. You are seeing from here filter option. Filter option, now what you are able to see that this part. So if I'll be clicking on this arrow, this was the arrow which was generated from here. This one is the arrow. If I'll be clicking on this, so you are seeing that check boxes are there. If I'll be unchecking this 440 and removing also this 350, so what will happen? These values will disappear from here. So you are not seeing these values. Two values, 440 and 350, has been removed. If I'll be again selecting it, so it will be getting selected. So this method is auto filter. Means auto filter means basically on the basis of just by checking or just by clicking or selecting or deselecting the data, that is auto filter. The second method we can use is the advanced filter. Advanced filter is used to filter the data in multiple fields. I have discussed also advanced data is means we can use the data in multiple fields. So that, and the two conditions or two options will be there, least range List range is the range of cell that you want to filter. That is the list range. And the criteria range. So criteria range is the range which is on the basis of which the condition will be applied. So this entire data is known as my list range, and this data is known as the criteria edge range. And this I have specified also that maths should be greater than equal to 50, science should be greater than equal to 70, and English should be greater than equal to 30. If the marks scored by the student is greater than equal to 50, science greater than equal to 70, and English greater than equal to 30. So what will happen? The only that student marks will be shown, or that will be only displayed. This is known as criteria range, means the eligibility, or we can say the minimum qualification marks. So that is we are defining. So that is one of the way of filtering the data. So how it will be working, how the output will be shown. So first of all, I'll be going to click the data tab. Data tab again. We are discussing how to do advanced filter. So in advanced filter, when we'll be doing, we'll be selecting, first of all, we'll be going to advanced option, and then I'll be selecting the ranges of cells. I've selected this range of cell. Now the second column, that is the criteria range. I am selecting criteria range, and as I told earlier, only Neha and Anant will be qualified, because all the other subject in maths, Nisa has not qualified and other have qualified, and here except Anant and Neha, no one has qualified in science. So you'll be seeing only the data of Neha and Anant. So if I'll be selecting, so what are the data which is coming up? Neha and Anant. So this is known as advanced filter. Advanced filter means filtering the data with respect to the criteria range. Criteria range, and the least range is the data from which this data has been generated. So this is the least range, and this is the selected or the filtered data, means the actual data which I am wanting, means the qualified people or the people according to our desired condition. This is the range. So again, we'll be moving to now the goal-seek. Goal-seek is basically one of the method in which we have to generate the output by, suppose four examinations has been conducted. If I am saying four examination has been conducted, see, four examination has been conducted. See, so what I have to do here means I am waiting for my examination of science. So what I will be doing here, that if I will be calculating the percentage according to the what I will be getting. So what I will be getting if science exam has not been conducted, and what is the percentage till now I am getting. So double equal to, then average I will be writing, average, then selecting some ranges. G5 average, then we have to select the ranges from G5 to G9. These ranges has been selected. I want this data to be, so it is automatically showing 70.5. now I have to see that how much marks I will be getting in science, so that I will be getting 75% overall, 75%. For this we have to apply goal-seek. So for goal-seek, I have to move to data menu. As I am already in the data menu, so you will be moving directly to what if analysis option. And if I'll be selecting goal seek, so three values are there. First is set value. Set value means where you want to set value, means what is the percentage criteria you want. Means if you'll be giving science examination and you want 75%, so how much you should be scoring in science. So that is the set value. You'll be finding that how much percentage you are desiring, 75%. So I have selected that cell, set cell, means where I want to change the value with respect to the value of science, means how much marks I'll be getting in science, according to which the percentage will be also changing, because science exam has not been conducted till now. If I'll be adding my percentage, so I am getting 70.5. so this is set value. Now two value means what value I want, 75. So I'll be adding here 75. Now changing the value, which value you want to change by changing cell. Changing cell means where the value has to be satisfied or where the value has to be filled. So this is the place where the value has to be filled or desired. From here the science examination will be conducted and its value will be filled. So if I'll be selecting here this, so this is showing G9. So here the value will be updated, and what is the value with respect to that, the percentage will be shown, that 75% desired percentage. So if I'll be clicking here, then you are seeing the result going on, and at last we have been generated that if the marks scored in science is 93, then the percentage is also changed, 75, because that was my desired percentage. So you should be scoring 93 marks in science, then in order to get 75%. So this is goal seek method. So goal seek is basically defining the ranges, means how we can obtain the output, means result is given to us. Now we have to see, means result we are predicting, and we have to find the input, what suitable input should I be giving so that I can get a particular result or favorable result which I want, or the desirable result which I wanted. So that is possible with the help of goal seek method. So again I will be moving to how to print. So printing a worksheet means if I will be clicking on to print a worksheet, follow the following step. Open the worksheet you want to print, and now file option I'll be going. This is the worksheet if I'll be wanting to print. Now file option I'll be going, then I'll be clicking on print option. This is the print option I am having, and if I'll be clicking on this, so this is the worksheet which, and now many options are there. You can select the how many copies you want to print. So one it is showing, you can change the number of copies if you wanted to print, and which way you want to print active, which printer is ready. So you can select the printer, or which printer you will be selecting, the size of the paper also you can select. This is portrait, landscape mode also you can use, portrait or landscape mode, both the way you can print. So this is, you are seeing, able to see the data. This will be printed in this format. So this is, and you can scale also. So this is print preview menu. So with respect to that, we are finding the how it will be looking, or while it is printed. So this is basically on the basis of when we'll be going to print option, and then finally click on the print option. If you'll be clicking on the print option, so it will be printed, and printer properties also you can select which kind of orientation you want. So these are the options which is available, and number of copies also you can select, that how many copies you want, 1 copy, 2 copy, 50 copy, you can select directly. So this is chapter 4. So we have completed chapter 4. If you are having any doubt, so you can ask us in our WhatsApp group, and we'll be discussing the question answers related to it, and you try these steps And if you are facing any while doing this, if you are facing any problem, then you can ask us, and you can ask in our WhatsApp group. Okay, thank you, students. So hopefully you should have understood it, and I should appreciate you that you should be trying this, and you should try more and more things, not only the things which I told. You can implement some more things with respect to that, and you can show us, and you can ask us in our WhatsApp group. Okay, thank you.